This is about as good as it gets, ladies and gentlemen. The open road. Hello, donkeys. Got a few donkeys creeping up on me here. Yeah? How's it, Oakies? What's up? Tumor's got her home here, dinner dates. I really am impressed with the Aussies. I've always loved this engine, one of my favorite turbo diesels. And matted to an affordable platform, it really does come to play. I will say the 4x2, you notice the difference off-road. It's a little bit more squirrely. So if you're going to be doing a lot of gravel roading, I would be tempted to pay a bit extra and get the 4x4 version of this. But it's nice with the D-Max coming that they're keeping the version of this car that's still basic, rugged, go anywhere. And that's what a lot of people are looking for, ladies and gentlemen. Certainly what I'm looking for. So all in all, one hell of a package. And starting price at around 450,000 Rand for the entry-level model, you're getting a lot of truck for your money. Solidly made, tough as teeth, great towing capacity. You can put a ton on the back. A great all-around vehicle, the new X-Rider. Back to the back. Thank you. So far the gravis have been doing well. Done about 100-150 k's of gravel. And everything's still going alright. Not a bad tacky, pretty firm. Looks good. We've got some zebras here, ladies and gentlemen. Hiya, big guy. Beautiful.
Bing. Thank you.
of the best features on this car that I haven't seen on a lot of other cars is there's one button clearly visible to turn the screen off. If you don't always want to have the screen on, you can just press that button and off she goes. And you hold it down and it goes fully off. Oh, Susie, you got a proper truck here. I think some of the wind noise in this car was to do when it was a very windy day earlier, because now it's not that bad. Really sits smoothly on the highway. It's riding smoother since it's been on the gravel. And I think these kind of cars like getting out and about and doing their thing. They're not actually built for the city, but they can perform in the city quite admirably. And if you'd like to support the creation of more content on Africa Sideways, car reviews, overlanding talk, 4x4 adventures, etc., etc., please hit the thanks button at the bottom of the screen next to the thumbs up.